Hi, my name is Jeffrey Lin. I'm a product manager here at ObEN. I'm part of a team that is working to create new products out of the technologies that are coming out of ObEN. So what is a personal artificial intelligence? What is a PAI? And what can users do with their PAI? Personal AI, or PAI, is a virtual avatar that can be used in the digital space. It can be used in virtual reality, in augmented reality, anywhere in the digital space. And most importantly, it's an avatar that is almost an exact replica of yourself. So it can look like you, it will sound like you, and it will actually behave like you based off of your own preferences. A user's PAI is essentially an extension of themselves in the digital space. So they can imagine having your own copy of yourself being able to do anything that you would want it to do in the digital world, such as helping you with shopping, being your personal assistant when you're not there, helping you make decisions on traveling, on helping you guide towards your healthcare options, right, going through online systems and services. And PAIs can actually do anything a lot for you when you're not there to do it. So they can help you drive decisions that knows that you would have preferences on. It can actually speak different languages that you yourself cannot speak. And the general idea here is that PAI can essentially help save up time that to let you do things that you would rather do, and not the boring, mundane tasks that are laborious on the digital space. What can developers do with PAI technology? The blockchain protocol developed by Project PAI is open source, and the personal AI is also open source. So developers can use both the blockchain protocol to secure personal AI and actually access the personal AI to be used for a variety of experiences such as healthcare, dating, socializing, retail, shopping, all wide varieties of even enterprise aspects. Project PAI is developing an open source blockchain protocol, and ObEN is actually developing the personal AI to be used as an open source API that can be built on top of the protocol. So imagine any developer that wants to create a PAI-enabled experience, any experience that is digital that wants to use a personal AI can actually pull our API and actually deploy it onto the blockchain for security, for scalability, and basically access a whole network of other users who are using PAI. What are some healthcare use cases for PAI? For example, the Lipo Group, which is partnered with Project PAI, is a healthcare organization that is planning to use PAI for creating virtual avatars of their doctors and their pharmacists. So if you imagine someone who needs to take medication, they might be able to get reminders from their pharmacist. They might be able to get reminders from their pharmacist's PAI. They can even get updates or appointment reminders from their doctor's PAI. The issue here is that there's a high cost associated with people who forget to take their medication to get to their appointments on time, and that ends up trickling down and costing both healthcare systems and patients time and money. But with a PAI, a pharmacist can send their PAI out to a patient to be reminded online to take their medication on a daily basis. A doctor can send their PAI out to their patient to send them a video message reminder to come to an appointment on time, so as not to enact all these additional costs and fees. What are some social use cases for PAI? A PAI enables a user to be able to express themselves creatively in more ways than one. Users might be able to send video messages of their own PAI dancing around or emotionally expressing something that they have felt but don't have the means to physically express it, either in video or traditional phone calls or audio messages or text messages. A user might be able to send their personal AI and send it as a video message to their friends to creatively express a frustration they felt about their day at work, or be able to use their PAI to express happiness at someone else's new event or something to celebrate on. Another social use case on PAI is being able to tell bedtime stories for your children. ObEN's co-founders actually designed a lot of the technology off the premise of the frustration of not being able to talk and see their children while they were at home. So they actually developed a PAI to allow PAI to be left behind and read bedtime stories to their children. So when they're traveling abroad and running around, their PAI can be there and speak with their children, and so their children don't feel as lonely as they did before. It's much more easily relatable to my friends when I send them my PAI, and they can more closely relate the things that they're seeing to my actual face. And especially if they know my personality and my little quirks and my habits, being able to see my PAI and act as actual expressions they've seen me enact before makes it all the more realistic, all the more relatable, and all the more enjoyable. One of the experiences that ObEN is developing is a speech-to-singing experience where you can then take your own voice, imbue it in your PAI, and then send your PAI out to your friends and families and dancing to that same music or song that you're singing.